Hey there, I'm Nate, this is the 80-20 Drummer, and today we're breaking down 7 shuffle beats every drummer should know. Let's roll them! Shuffle number 1, the Art Blakey Moaning Shuffle. The shuffle that forms the basis for a lot of the beats that we're going to cover was made famous by the singular Art Blakey. Blakey formed the Jazz Messengers, who recorded their first album in 1947. And the song you're listening to, Moaning, in October of 1958. And it featured Lee Morgan, who played this iconic trumpet solo. Now, let's talk about how to play it, in 1 minute or less. So the Moaning Shuffle by Blakey is actually one of the more complicated ones we'll learn, but it's earlier in the canon, so we should learn it first. So if you take away the left hand, you're really just playing the 4-on-the-floor swing beat. 3, 4. Where of course you're doing the spangling with the right hand and left foot. And you're playing the kick drum, not super loud, but solidly on all fours. 3, 4. The tough part is this molar drop catch thing with the left hand. If you're playing it faster, and you can even do it with a rim shot. Putting it all together, 3, 4. And that's the Blakey Shuffle. Before we go on to the next beat, I should mention that if you need a transcription of any of the beats in this lesson, we made you a workbook. You can grab it by clicking the link below the player, so no need to transcribe all these beats by yourself. Okay, on to shuffle number 2.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend, and
Shuffle 2, the Johnny Cash Fluke Holland Train Shuffle. In January of 1968, Johnny Cash, along with longtime drummer W.S. Fluke Holland, recorded Live at Folsom Prison, which shot not only to the top of the country charts, but also to the top of the top 40 charts. While hardly the first example of the beat that came to be known as the train shuffle, which, let me just demonstrate that quickly. In its most common form, it's just 3, 4. But Folsom Prison Blues from Live at Folsom Prison might be the best example ever captured on recording. In the early 2000s, a friend actually took a lesson with Fluke Holland and reported excitedly that he'd gotten the real Johnny Cash beat. Here's what he came back with. 3, 4. So just like the Blakey Shuffle, we'll talk about the non-snare drum hands and feet first. And if you watch Fluke play this, he moves his hands all over the place and sometimes he goes to the regular train shuffle, but we're covering the particular variant with the hand on the hats. And that's just 3, 4. Super simple, right? The problem comes with the left hand, which goes 3, 4. Slow that down. 3, 4. You don't always have to play rim shots on this. You can play it a little bit lighter, just in the center of the drum too. 3, 4. And that's the Fluke Holland Johnny Cash shuffle. Got it? Before I lose some of you, you might be wondering, hey, how come you're only covering old beats? Aren't you gonna cover some of the more famous contemporary shuffles? The answer is yes, but I also wanna introduce you to the roots of this beat. And many of these earlier beats are nasty as hell. Cool? Okay, on to number 3. Shuffle 3, the Slow Roadhouse Muddy Waters Shuffle. Now, if you listen closely to this Muddy Waters shuffle, recorded in 1955 with Frederick Bellow Jr. on drums, you probably recognize the beat from such things as beer commercials. But this beat has also made its way into lots of contemporary music, including this classic from the early 90s. And one of my favorite sort of fusion-y examples, the tune John's Blues from Vinnie Colaiuta's solo album. It all comes back to Muddy Waters and his influences before him. Let's talk about how to play this beat. So this beat is a lot slower, and we're thinking of it like a 12-8 or a 4-4 with triplets, and we're playing all of the triplets on the hats. So the hands will go 3, 4. And if you want to play the basic version, you can just add the kick drum on 1 and 3. So 3. And I like to think of this as the bow bow down bow beat. And one thing you remember with the bow bow down bow is that a lot of times in practice, the bass drum plays a. And for this beat, I like to keep the hi-hats a little low and a little loose generally, and I like to bring that rim shot out. And that's how to play the basic, slow, Muddy Waters Roadhouse Shuffle. Cool? Now for a beat I better cover, lest Texas secede from the Union. Can I say that on YouTube? Or will they take this video? Still here. Shuffle 4. The Texas Shuffle. The modern song that exemplifies the Texas Shuffle is most probably Pride and Joy by Stevie Ray Vaughan, with Chris Layton on drums. But Texas blues has deep roots from artists like Lightnin' Hopkins, Little Son Jackson, and T-Bone Walker. Here's a bit of Chris Layton explaining how he plays the Texas Shuffle.
You know, the left hand thing, which is kind of like a, you know, you could call it a dotted pattern with what I call is the rub in the middle, which is kind of a Texas thing. You know, with coming in on the downbeat.
And to keep this short, I won't reiterate everything Chris just said, but here are a few things I discovered that made it easier to play. So there are really two ways to play this. The way that Chris Layton demonstrates is good for slower tempos. And the coordination trick is, you play that buzzed grace note at the same time you play the gah of Spang-a-Lang. So to get into it, you could just practice 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And the rest, I would just follow what Chris says. Of course, for quicker tunes like Pride and Joy, you're probably not going to be catching those grace notes quite as much. And in effect, what the Texas Shuffle ends up being is a little like a Blakey Shuffle missing the first note. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's how you play the Texas Shuffle. Our next beat brings us firmly into fusion territory. Babylon Sister. Steely Dan released Babylon Sisters as part of their album Gaucho in 1980. Bernard Purdy, who played on the tune, had this to say.
Now, they already told me that they didn't want a shuffle. They didn't want the Motown. They didn't want the Chicago. But they weren't sure how and what they wanted, but they did want halftime. I said, fine, then let me do the Purdy Shuffle.
There are a lot of versions of the Purdy Shuffle, but here's how the most basic version goes. So the version I play goes like this. 3, 4. Let me slow that down. So the key thing you want to get in your head is, which by the way, if you study Bataille, is also the way the first part of the Oru Seko goes, I think. I think I remember that. Totally random note. Anyway, you're going, and you just put the snare drum rim shot on the second half of that. So 3, 4. Now, some people like to do a double ghost note. So 3, 4. And generally, I'll only do that if I'm not doing a pickup note on the kick drum. Anyway, that's how I play the basic Purdy Shuffle. Now, let's talk about a beat the Purdy Shuffle inspired. Shuffle 6, the Rosanna Shuffle. Now, if you follow the channel, you'll know that just last week, I broke down 7 covers of this tune and played my own drum cover. Let's talk about how to play it. So, you're starting with the Purdy Shuffle. And you're just adding kind of a clave with the kick drum. 3, 4. Certain people get really exacting about the hi-hat accents. Like you want to go. For me, I consider that extra credit. You really just want to have a nice flow and swung kind of groove with it. 3, 4. And that's how you play the Rosanna Shuffle. Finally, a shuffle beat I think can trace its roots back to Muddy Waters. Which wears an electronic Brit rock set of clothes. Shuffle 7, Everybody Wants to Rule the World. Tears for Fears released Everybody Wants to Rule the World in 1985, and it became the emblematic song that represented the group. On drums was Manny Elias. Here's how I would approach that beat. So when you get right down to it, it's just a sped up Muddy Waters beat. Remember the Muddy Waters beat? Bow, bow, no, down, down. 2, 3, bum, 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 bum. And what's the Tears for Fears beat? Bum, bada, bada, bum. Couple little variations you can throw in. You can accent the downbeats on the hats. So 3, 4. Which will give it a little more of a propulsive thing, or you can play it more drum machine-ish and try to play all of the hat notes even. Personally, I like a little accent. 3, 4. I think that's in the eye of the beholder. And that's how you play the Everybody Wants to Rule the World Shuffle from Manny Elias. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this roundup of the 7 essential shuffles every drummer should know. I've doubtless left out quite a bunch of them. And I'll be the first to say this lesson is probably far from perfect. If you know another crucial shuffle, feel free to write me a polite comment below. And remember, if you'd like a complete transcription of all of the beats we covered in this lesson, just click the link below the player and enter your email address in on the next page, and you can download that. You can choose to subscribe to my mailing list, where I'll also send you my 3 video mini course completely free, which will make you better in the next 3 weeks than you've gotten in the previous 6 months. Or you can just grab the transcription free and clear, no mailing list subscription required. Either way, hope you enjoyed this one. I had a lot of fun. See you again next time on another lesson of the week.